Hello dear learners, welcome to IFS. In today's session, we will be discussing about the vulva formation in C. elegans. So this topic is taken from developmental biology. Now, why developmental biology? So in this unit, it is really very important to know that it is really a very scoring unit. Talking first, let's discuss about the unit itself. The unit is really very scoring. Why is it scoring? Because there are some selective topics from which questions are definitely asked in your competitive exam. Moreover, the pattern of question, if you see, the pattern of question is generally statement based. Statement based means generally it is asked to figure out the correct ones or to identify the odd one out from a given set of sentences. Yes, so there are generally statement based questions, and moreover, there can be questions on which mutations is applied. Like for example, if a specific gene is mutated, which kind of developmental effect or developmental defect will be seen? So such kind of questions generally are asked in this unit, that is developmental biology. And one among the topic I have chosen to explain you, that is vulva formation in C. elegans. So first of all, let's discuss that what are C. elegans. Do you know what are C. elegans? Yes, you should know that C. elegans, they are what? They belong to phylum nematodes, and phylum nematode is generally known for the presence of roundworms. Yes, phylum nematodes, it belongs to kingdom Animalia, phylum nematodes, which is predominantly consist of roundworms. Now it is a model organism for study. Generally C. elegans is considered as a model organism. Why it is considered as a model organism? There are many reasons. One among them is less number of cells. Okay, less number of cells, only 959 cells are present. And moreover, if I say the lifespan, also it is transparent, so it's easier to study its structure. So these are some factors which helps to study it easily. So hence considered as what? Hence considered as model organism. Also it is a hermaphrodite. What do you mean by a hermaphrodite? If I talk about a hermaphrodite, hermaphrodites are those which consist of both male and female sex organs or reproductive parts. Yes, talking about the hermaphrodites, they can be also considered as bisexual. They can be what? They can be also considered or said as bisexual. So in C. elegans, both male and female reproductive organs are present. Now, what is vulva? Talking about vulva, vulva will be the female reproductive part. Vulva will be what? It will be the part of female. Now, generally in C. elegans, what occurs is like, the since they are hermaphrodites in nature, okay, so the male reproductive part synthesizes sperms and stores it. And through that vulva, then it reaches the egg to fertilize it. If vulva is absent, then this all process cannot be done. So let's discuss about the vulva. See here, I have taken a diagram also. See, it's generally a worm which is 1 millimeter long. Yes. And this is vulva. The head and the neck consisting of the egg cells also. So vulva is what? It is a kind of opening through which eggs are laid into the environment. Okay, and also it serves as a passage for the movement of sperm towards the female gamete. Fine. Now, what is vulva here? Discussing about vulva, vulva is a part of female sex apparatus. See here. Yes, it is a part of what? It is a part of female sex apparatus. It helps in laying eggs into the environment, generally in the soil. Yes, and also it acts as a passage for the movement of sperm towards the female gamete. So now we will be discussing how this aperture is formed. Yes, how its development occurs, which kind of signaling plays an important role in its development. Let's discuss about all these things. I hope the basic things are clear to you. That is, we are discussing about a roundworm. Yes, which belongs to nematodes. Yes. And that is C. elegans. And why we are studying it? Since it is really very simple to study it. It is made up of less number of cells. Both male and female can be studied in the same organism. It is transparent. as well as it has a shorter lifespan. Yes, and vulva, it is a organ. Yes, it is a organ that facilitates what? It facilitates egg laying and movement of sperm towards the female gamete. So here we are discussing about a organ differentiation. Yes, this topic will be broadly discussed under that. Yes, so here we are discussing what? How vulva will be developed. Let's discuss about it. More importantly, it is important that what is the position of vulva. Here, let's read in the slide first of all that the vulva is made up of 22 cells. How many cells? 22 cells. The adult vulva is made up of 22 cells which rearrange their positions to construct the vulva. Adult vulval cells or the adult hermaphrodite, which is consisting of vulva, it will be made up of 22 cells. And the position is really very important. If the position differs, then there will be no fertilization. Okay, if it develops in wrong place, so the sperm will be not fertilized, and hence the cells, egg cells, will never be fertilized. So the positioning of vulva related to the gonads. What are gonads? Yes, cells, reproductive cells, basically cells which will produce the gametes. Yes, which will produce the gametes. So it is really a very critical aspect that vulva is positioned at a proper place. Now, how this is ensured that positioning is at proper place? Let's discuss about that. So the positional information needed by, okay, the positional information needed by the vulva progenitor cell is provided by a cell within the gonad. Okay, there is, like, if this is suppose, okay, if this is suppose the C. elegans, there is a presence of here a gonad, and there is a presence of what? There is a presence of an anchor cell. There is presence of what? There is presence of an anchor cell. Okay, and this anchor cell, what it does? It signals. It gives signals, yes, in the form of protein called as LIN3. Means, what I'm saying here is that there is a presence of what? There is a presence of anchor cell. Yes, suppose this is an anchor cell. Now, this anchor cell will release what? It will release LIN3 protein. Yes, it will release what? LIN3 protein. And this LIN3 will decide which cell will become a vulva, and hence the positioning will be decided. So anchor cells plays an important role in deciding the positioning of the vulva. Clear everyone? I hope crystal clear. This anchor cell is really very important. Often questions are asked about if anchor cells are destroyed, what will happen. We'll discuss this in the further discussion. So the signaling, so the positioning, the first thing that I have discussed is the positioning of vulva is really very important, and the positioning is ensured by anchor cells. And what are anchor cells? They basically, what they are present in the gonad, and they secrete what? They secrete LIN3 protein. And of course, the LIN3 protein is encoded by the LIN3 gene. Which gene? The LIN3 gene. Yes. Now, the vulval development. Now, these, if I discuss here, these three points can be the main points of vulval development. Okay. So, these points will be considered in the vulva development process. So, in vulva development process, three major step occurs. Yes. Three major step occurs. The first one is generation of vulval precursor cells. First of all, what occurs? Six vulval precursor cells are specified, which are located on the ventral epidermis. See, here, if this is the C. elegans, so here six six vulval precursor cells are present. Yes, these are what? These are six VPCs. Okay, and they are located in the on the ventral epidermis. Hence, we can also say that the what the vulva is present on the ventral side. Yes. So now these vulval precursor cells are generated. Okay, there is a set of cells. Yes, in which we identify six vulval precursor cells. Now these vulval precursor cells undergoes a specific kind of patterning. What they undergo? They undergo a specific kind of patterning. And what patterning? A signal from the gonad and signaling among the VPCs specifies three vulval precursor cells, VPCs. So signaling is from where? It is from the anchor cell. Yes, as I have discussed right now, signaling is from where? It is from the anchor cell. Anchor cells, yes, they secrete what? They secrete LIN3 protein. And then LIN3 protein will specify these vulval precursor cells into three types. That is the primary, the secondary, and the uninduced, which will not get the signal. They will be divided into a tertiary lineage. Okay? Now, the primary and the secondary and the tertiary will have different fate. Right now, after this, I will be explaining you the pathway itself. And then, finally, the adult cells will be generated and a vulva will be created. So, vulva development process can be studied under these three heads. Let's discuss how it occurs. Okay, let's discuss how it occurs. So, let's make this. So, suppose this is what? This is the elegant. This is the positioning of gonad comprising of the anchor cell. Yes, comprising of what? Comprising of the anchor cell, and towards this surface only there will be the presence of what? Six vulval precursor cells. Yes, this will be the six vulval precursor cells. Now, these VPCs are also termed as group of equivalent cells. What they are termed as? They are termed as group of equivalent cell. And this is due to the fact that they all have the ability to form a vulva. But due to different kind of signaling, their fate will be determined. Yes? So, let's discuss these things in detail. Which kind of signaling will occur? Let's take it, discuss all that in detail. Yes? So, here, suppose this is the, let me highlight the anchor cell with the help of a yellow pen. Okay, so this is the anchor cell. Yes, this is what? This is the anchor cell. Now, this anchor cell, what it does? It releases LIN3 protein, which is encoded by LIN3 gene as an inductive signal. Yes, as in what? As an inductive signal. And also there is what? There is a presence of vulval precursor cells here. Yes or no? There will be a presence of what? Vulval precursor cells. So these are the vulval precursor cells. Yes. So, these are what? These are the vulval precursor cells. We can name them as P3P cells, P4P cells, P5P cells. Yes, these are what? These are the six vulval precursor cells. Now, the anchor cell, which is releasing the LIN3 as an inductive signal, see, here, the concentration of LIN3 will be more received by the cells which are nearer to the anchor cell as compared to those which are further away. Yes? So the concentration, these molecules are what? These molecules are of LIN3. So the signaling molecule, that is LIN3 protein, it will be received more by the cells which are closer to the anchor cell, whereas those which are farther away, they will receive less or negligible. They will receive less or negligible. Now, if there is a presence of inductive signal, there must be what? There must be a receptor for it also. So the receptor that is present on these vulval precursor cells are the late 23 receptors. Which receptors? The late 23 receptors. Late 23 receptors. These receptors are a type of RTK. They are what? They are a type of RTK. Receptor tyrosine kinase, which will trigger the MAPK pathway, mitogen activating protein kinase pathway. Yes or no? Yes, they will interact. Means there will be what? There will be interaction of the what? The LIN-3 protein with late 23. Yes. And there will be a series of signaling resulting in what? Resulting in expression of proteins which will trigger the formation of vulva. Which will trigger what? Which will trigger the formation of vulva. Now, the cell which is receiving amongst these six vulval precursor cell, the cell which is receiving more amount of LIN-3. Yes, the cell which is much more closer to the anchor cell, it will be, this is the P6P, it will form the vulva. What it will form? It will form the vulva. Yes, it will participate in central vulva formation. Yes, okay, means it has taken the primary fate. What it has taken? It has taken the primary fate. These are also termed as primary vulval precursor cells. What they are termed as? They are termed as primary vulval precursor cells. Whereas those like here, they will receive less amount of LIN-3 protein. Yes, they will receive less amount of LIN-3 protein. Yes or no? And like P3, P68, P6P it is. These will receive negligible. This will receive negligible. So those which are receiving negligible, yes, those which are receiving negligible, they get differentiated to skin. That is the hypodermis. Yes, that is what? The hypodermis. Okay, this will be also converted into hypodermis. And this will be also converted into hypodermis, forming the skin, part of skin. Yes? Whereas the two, that is lateral or adjacent to the main, they will secure a secondary fate. These. Yes? These. They will form the lateral vulva, or they will form the lining of vulva. Okay? They will form the lateral vulva or lining. Lining of vulva. Yes. That is the lining of vulva. They will be what? They will be forming the lining of vulva. So they are taking the secondary fate. They are taking what? The secondary fate. Yes, they are taking what? The secondary fate. They are the secondary vulval precursor cells. They are what? They are the secondary vulval precursor cells. Whereas those forming the skin, they will be termed as what? They will be termed as the tertiary ones. They will be termed as what? They will be termed as the tertiary ones. Yes? Is it clear? Yes or no, everyone? So, this is how the signaling occurs, and the vulval precursor cells are differentiated into the primary, secondary and tertiary. Yes? They are differentiated into the primary. You can please see it. Have a quicker look. That this kind of signaling occurs, and what? LIN-3 interacts with late 23 receptor, and this activates a MAPK pathway, yes, which will lead to the expression of vulval formation proteins, that is vulva formation proteins. Now, here, this is formed due to what? Due to the inductive signal of LIN-3. But these lateral vulval precursor cells, what? The lateral vulval precursor cells, how they are formed basically? Talking about these lateral vulval precursor cells, they are formed due to lateral inhibition. Yes? Since see, they are also receiving LIN-3 signals. So why they are not differentiating into vulva? Yes? So here, a kind of lateral inhibition occurs. Yes? What occurs? A kind of lateral inhibition. The The precursor cell, which is forming the vulva, it will express proteins. Yes, it will express proteins which will inhibit the formation of vulva in the lateral cells. They will form the lining of vulva, and that is called as lateral inhibition. What it is called as? It is called as lateral inhibition. Yes, everyone? I hope this is crystal clear to you. Right now, we have discussed about the inductive signal. Now, let's discuss about this lateral inhibition. That what kind of lateral inhibition occurs that it does not form the vulva. Yes? Let's try to understand lateral inhibition now. So, up till now, what we have discussed is what that there is what? This is the anchor cell which has produced a LIN3 signal, which is an inductive signal, and there is a presence of 6 vulval precursor cells. Yes, this has taken the fate of vulva. Yes, and these two, the ones which are present further away from the anchor cell, their fate is the hypodermis. Now these two, yes, these two, why they are making the lining? Yes, why they are making the lining of the vulva? They are also receiving the LIN3 signal, yes or no? But why they are not getting determined into vulva? Instead, they are getting determined into the lining of the vulva, that is, they are adapting the secondary fate. How this happens? This occurs due to lateral inhibition. It occurs due to what? It occurs due to lateral inhibition. Let's enlarge these cells and discuss about them. Okay, let's enlarge these cells and discuss about them. Let's enlarge these three cells. So this is the main cell which is taking the primary fate, that is forming the vulva. So there is the interaction of LIN3 with late 23. When this interaction occurs, there is a triggering. Yes, there is an activation or a triggering of what? MAPK pathway. Yes, MAPK pathway. And due to this, late 31 is expressed. Which protein is expressed? Late 31 protein is expressed. And this late 31 protein, which is expressed, this will act as a transcription factor for the expression of acts as a transcription factor. Yes, it acts as what? It acts as a transcription factor for the expression of other genes of vulval formation. For the expression of other genes of vulval formation. Now, along with this, what occurs? There is an expression of vul proteins. Yes, there is expression of vul proteins here. VUL proteins. Yes, there is an expression of these are what? These are transmembrane proteins which are expressed on these cells. Now, what happens? This is another vulval precursor cell. This consists of a receptor. Which receptor? The LIN12 receptor. Which receptor? The LIN12 receptor. Now, there is the interaction between the LIN12 receptor and the vulval proteins. Yes, there is the interaction between what? The interaction between LIN12 receptors and vulval protein. And in turn, it inhibits what? It inhibits the late 23 receptor. This interaction will inhibit here. Yes, this interaction will inhibit this. So, this cannot form the vulva. Yes, this is what? This is a kind of lateral inhibition. This is what? This is a kind of lateral inhibition. Similarly, will be the case of the cell which is present here? Yes or no? Yes or no? So what happens? There is an expression of transmembrane proteins like the vul proteins. It interacts with LIN12 receptors which are present on the adjacent vulval precursor cells. Now these adjacent vulval precursor cells, what they do? Whenever there is an interaction between the LIN12 receptors and the vul proteins, there is an inhibition in the late 23 receptor, and hence this pathway cannot be activated. They will form the lateral vulval cells. They will form the lining of the vulva. What will they do? They will form the lining of the vulva. So here, yes, here what? Here it is important to note down that, yes, both what induction and both induction and lateral inhibition, yes, both induction and lateral inhibition results in the formation of vulva, yes, results in the formation of vulva, in the formation of vulva. See, this will occur in both the cell which is adjacent here as well as the cell which is present here. Okay, I've shown you in only one cell. Yes, is it clear, everyone? So this is how the signaling occurs. Yes, so the six vulval precursor cells, they are a group of cells which shows equivalence. They all can form the vulva, but depending upon the signal they are receiving, yes, depending upon the signaling they are undergoing, they take up different fate as primary, secondary and tertiary. Those taking primary will form the vulva. Those taking secondary will form what? They will form the lining of the vulva, the lateral cells. Whereas those taking the tertiary fate will be forming the skin, that is the hypodermis. So let's, like whatever I have discussed till now, let's quickly review it. Come on, everyone. So whatever I have discussed till now, so this all things we have discussed. So this is what? This is what? The A diagram. What does it represent? It represents the C. elegans. Yes, it represents what? It represents the C. elegans comprising of the gonad. Yes, within which there is a presence of what? There is a presence of anchor cell and six vulval precursor cells. Yes, six vulval precursor cells. Now, these six vulval precursor cells are P3P, P4P, P5, P6, P7, P8. Now, the anchor cell will release what? It will release a LIN3 protein as a signal, which will interact with LAT23 receptor and it will give which fate? The vulva formation fate to that cell. Yes? See, this was the primary one, the primary fate. Can you see here? There is the secretion of an inductive signal, that is LIN3, which activates P6P, yes, and it forms what? It forms vulva. So anchor cell is giving what? It is secreting LIN3 protein, which is interacting with LAT23 receptor, yes. And what, along with this, what happens? Along with this, there is an expression of transmembrane proteins, which will interact with whom? The transmembrane proteins will interact with the LIN12 receptors, and as a result, these will take what? These will take a secondary fate, that is, they will be forming the vulval lining. They will be the lateral cells. They will be forming the lining of vulva, whereas the remaining ones, they will be what? They will be forming the hypodermis, that is the skin. So this is all only what we have discussed. You can see here, it is just a simple look of what we have studied, what I have written in the two slides previously. It is all diagrammatically explained here. Yes, there is the presence of this protein. Yes, VUL protein I have mentioned there. Yes, which interacts with the LIL-12 receptor. And then what occurs? There occurs lateral inhibition. So this here, the vulva formation is due to induction, whereas the vulval lining formation is due to lateral inhibition. Now, what kind of questions can be asked from this topic? Basically, the topic ends here. It is really a very simple topic, and you need to remember these receptors and these signaling molecules only. And moreover, now discussing about what? Discussing about which kind of questions can be asked from the topic. So, discussing about the questions, what will happen? Yes. What will happen if anchor cell is destroyed? If anchor cell is destroyed, what will happen? So see, if the anchor cell is destroyed, the signal, the major signal that is responsible for differentiating the vulval precursor cells into the vulva Will it occur? Definitely not. So will there will be vulva formation? No vulva formation. In this case, there will be no vulva formation. Yes, there will be what? There will be no vulva formation. In another case, if I say, if I remove, yes, if I remove three vulval precursor cells, if I remove three vulval precursor cells, so the remaining three, can they form vulva? Definitely yes, because we require majorly three. The other three is forming skin only. There will be formation of vulva. Such kind of questions can be asked. Yes, such kind of questions are definitely asked from this topic. Even what will happen if the late 23 is mutated, or there is a complete absence of that receptor due to the defect in the gene. These questions can be asked. Yes, you can note down. Or basically, you can also think over, like if late 23 is mutated, what will happen? If LINT12 is mutated, what will happen? Yes, if LINT12 is mutated, late 23 is mutated, if the vulva protein is not expressed, what can be the resultant? These different types of questions can also come in your examination. That's all for today in the vulva formation. See, I'm not writing down each and every answer since I have explained you the whole topic. Just try to identify what will be the fate of vulva in these cases. Now, that's all for today, everyone. In this session, I will be discussing all this only. I hope you enjoyed the session. Thank you so much, everyone, and happy learning.